reflection on scripture within tradition. In our previous session, we reflected on how Jesus is the high point of revelation. He is God's final word to human beings. This is repeated in the Catechism of the Catholic Church, number 75. In it, we are told that in Christ the Lord, the entire revelation of the Most High God is summed up. In Christ, the promises of God are fulfilled. The gospel was promulgated by Christ. The gospel was then preached by the apostles. The apostles did what Jesus told them to do, as we read in Matthew 28, 19 to 20, to go out to all the nations and to preach the good news. He assured them of his presence with them always. They preached the gospel orally. They bore witness by the example of their lives. They, together with others, inspired by the Holy Spirit, wrote accounts and letters of their faith experiences. They established institutions so that what they had received from Christ and the Holy Spirit could be shared with others. They were persons on fire with the joy of the gospel. They were courageous and bold in bearing witness, as we read these days in the readings of the Easter season from the Acts of the Apostles. We notice a movement, a process of handing on. Jesus interacts with the apostles. As risen Lord, he gives them his spirit and he sends them out. And then the apostles preach the good news. They share with others. They hand on to others what they themselves have experienced. This process of handing on what they had experienced of Jesus is guided by the Holy Spirit. And it is called tradition. It is a term that is much debated in Christian circles. We as Catholics say that apostolic tradition is both the process of handing on and the content of what is handed on. By process, we mean how, the method of handing on. And by content, we mean what, the message that was handed on. Apostolic tradition, therefore, refers to both the process of handing on and the content of what was communicated by the apostles. What did the apostles hand on? The first letter of St. John in chapter 1, verses 2 and 3 tells us, "The eternal life which was with the Father and was made manifest to us, that which we have seen and heard, we proclaim." The apostles received what Jesus revealed. They responded in faith. They believed and trusted in him. As they reflected on this encounter, they began to express it in words so that they could communicate it to others, so that they could hand on their own experience to others. How did they hand it on? We saw this just a little while ago. By preaching, by writing, together with others who were inspired by the Holy Spirit, by the rituals that they celebrated, by the institutions that they set up, and by the very example of their lives. In all these ways, the apostles handed on to others what they had experienced. The written words or the written accounts gradually were collected together with letters, and the church, guided by the Holy Spirit, declared these as sacred scripture. It was through the process of handing on or tradition, guided by the Holy Spirit, that the scripture, as we know it today, came into existence. We look again at the Catechism of the Catholic Church, number 78. It quotes the Second Vatican Council's document, Dei Verbum, number 8, and tells us that what the Church hands on is all that she is, all that she believes, the whole life of the Church, her doctrine or teaching, her worship or prayer and rituals, the actions of her members, their conduct. In other words, all that the church is handed on through tradition. This is what the apostles did, and this is what the church continues to do. We look now at a consequence of what we have just said. Where is God's revelation to be found? Some Christians say, in Scripture alone. The Catholic Church says, in Scripture seen in the light of tradition. Or revelation is to be found in all that the apostles handed on, preaching and writing, rituals, their very life. In other words, scripture is of prime importance, but it is made possible because of tradition. Scripture and tradition cannot be separated. The Catechism of the Catholic Church, number 78, says again, this living transmission accomplished in the Holy Spirit is called tradition. It is distinct from sacred scripture, though closely connected to it. And again, in number 80, sacred tradition and sacred scripture then are bound closely together and communicate with one another. Scripture and tradition are distinct but united. We could depict this relationship in this way. Scripture has arisen through the process of tradition. Scripture is the most significant part of tradition. The two are not separated from each other, but form one reality. Scripture is to be interpreted in the light of tradition. The teaching authority of the Church, the magisterium as it is called, guides us in the interpretation of Scripture. The Catechism of the Catholic Church, number 79, tells us, the Father's self-communication made through His Word in the Holy Spirit remains present and active in the Church. God's revelation is now communicated through the Church. Number 79 continues now, quoting from the Second Vatican Council's document Dei Verbum number 8. It tells us that the Holy Spirit will lead us to understand the full truth that has already been revealed in Christ. The revelation in Christ is perfect and complete. We now grow in our understanding of that revelation through the guidance of the Holy Spirit. But the first part of this statement says something that makes us sit up. It says that God continues to converse. That means that God is still speaking, that revelation is still happening in the present. But in our earlier statements, and particularly in our previous session, we said that God has said everything in Christ. There is no further revelation. Is this then a contradiction? Revelation is complete, but it continues. It is not a contradiction, but viewing the same reality from two different viewpoints. From the point of view of content or message, revelation is complete. What God wanted to say in Jesus, in history, He has done it. He has said everything in His Son Jesus through His life, death, and resurrection. Revelation in terms of content is complete. From the viewpoint of encounter, revelation continues. God continues to speak to us. God continues to meet us. God continues to reveal Himself to us. Where does this happen? When the scriptures are read and proclaimed, when we celebrate the sacraments, which we miss so much during these days of the lockdown, when we are guided by God to do something good. In all these ways, God is communicating with us. All these experiences of God speaking to us take us back to that fundamental experience of the apostles, their encounter with the incarnate Jesus. The same Jesus continues now to speak to us, to meet us. What Jesus said to the apostles is the same thing that He says to us today. Nothing new. Revelation, therefore, continues as an encounter. Revelation as message or content is complete. We reflect further on the Holy Spirit leading us to the complete truth. Number 94 of the Catechism of the Catholic Church tells us that thanks to the assistance of the Holy Spirit, there is a growth in understanding of what has been revealed. How does this happen? Through the contemplation and study of believers who ponder these things in their hearts, particularly through theological research. We are not engaged in theological research, but we are pondering, we are reflecting, we are trying to understand more deeply the message of Christ. What we are doing right now is acknowledged by the teaching of the Church. When we reflect, when we think, when we try to understand Christ's message more deeply, we are contributing to the process of the growth in understanding. we are continuing in this journey of the church towards the complete truth. How else does this growth in understanding happen? From the intimate sense of spiritual realities which believers experience. Our spiritual encounters with the Lord in moments of prayer, in moments of silence, in meditation, in deep communion with the Lord, in all these we receive insights. And sometimes if we want to communicate these insights to others, we find it so difficult. The other person doesn't seem to get what we are saying. But we have experienced this within ourselves in our moments of prayer. These experiences also contribute towards a deepening of the understanding of what has been revealed. The paragraph quotes Saint Gregory the Great and says, "The sacred scriptures grow with the one who reads them." Wow, we grow with the scriptures. The fathers of the church often use images, sometimes with exaggeration, to communicate the message. Every time we go back to a passage of scripture and read it, we get some new insight. We realize something new. We are taken to a deeper level of understanding. Our understanding grows and we ourselves grow. Still further, the document tells us that our understanding grows from the preaching of those who have received, along with their right of succession in the episcopate, the sure charism of truth. This is referring to the preaching of the successors of the apostles, namely the bishops in union with the Pope, and all those who collaborate with them, priests and deacons, and those who have been formally authorized to teach. All these ways help us to get a better understanding of God's message. Through these ways, we receive deeper insights and we contribute towards a furthering of the understanding. We journey with the church towards the fullness of truth. Number 101 of the Catechism of the Catholic Church says, "In order to reveal himself to men in the condescension of his goodness, God speaks to them in human words." This word condescension is a word used by St. John Chrysostom. How would you communicate to your dog? "Rex, will you please come and have your meal?" "Rex, it is now time for us to go for a walk." No, you'll speak doggy language. "Rex, come, eat. Rex, let's go for a walk. Come on." If there's a little child in your house that's just learning to speak and the child now cries, you'll go up to the child and say, "Baba, what happened to you? Why are you crying? You got a hurt? Boo, boo. Okay, we'll give you medicine. Okay, don't cry." You speak baby language to a little child. To a dog, you'll speak doggy language. If God wanted to communicate to us as human beings, he would have to speak human language. And in order to do that, God becomes a human being in Jesus. The Word becomes flesh. This is what God condescends. He comes down to our level. He takes human flesh and becomes a human being with all the consequences that it entails. Number 101 continues quoting from De Verbum number 13, which draws a parallel between the incarnation and scripture. In the incarnation, the word of the eternal Father, the Son, takes human flesh. God becomes a human being. In the scriptures, the words of God are expressed in the words of men. God speaks human language. The scriptures bear witness to that great event, the Christ event, God becoming a human being so that he could speak to us as human beings, so that he could speak our human language, so that ultimately he could save us. Number 105 of the Catechism of the Catholic Church says, "God is the author of sacred scripture." This is a quotation from De Verbum number 11. And once again in number 106, the Catechism of the Catholic Church says, "God inspired the human authors of the sacred books. It was as true authors that they consigned to writing whatever he wanted written and no more." What these two statements are saying is that God is the author, But the human being, the writer, also inspired by God, is also called a true author. And we affirm this in the liturgy. It begins by saying a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans, or a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians, or a reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. And then at the end of the reading, the reader says, the word of God. The words of men and the word of God, both together in one place. What is meant is that the writing of scripture has God and human beings collaborating together. They are united. The scriptures bear witness to that event of God uniting himself with human beings. The Christ event, the new covenant. What is the covenant? The relationship between God and human beings. Christ fulfills or ratifies or seals the covenant. But even more, we should say, Christ is the covenant because he is fully human, he is fully divine, united perfectly in one person. God and human beings are united most perfectly in Christ. Scripture testifies to this. This great moment of our salvation, the new covenant, Jesus himself. Number 108 of the Catechism of the Catholic Church gives us some sound advice. Still, the Christian faith is not a religion of the book. Christianity is the religion of the Word of God, not a written and mute word, but incarnate and living. If the scriptures are not to remain a dead letter, Christ, the eternal Word of the living God, must, through the Holy Spirit, open our minds to understand the scriptures. This is a book, or many books put together. But the Bible is no ordinary book. It is precious to us. We have received it through tradition, but it is the most privileged part of tradition. And therefore, in our homes, we will give the Bible a privileged place, a place of honor. In the liturgy, we have special signs when we venerate the scriptures, the written word of God. But our faith is not in the book. Our faith is in the person of Jesus, the eternal word of God, who reveals himself through the written word. Our faith is in the person of Jesus, who manifests himself as we read through the books of the Bible, as we study and reflect and pray on all that is said in scripture. We encounter Jesus, the living and eternal Word of God. Through the pages of the Bible, we encounter Christ, the Word of God. Jesus is the Word of God. And that is the fundamental meaning of the term, and that gives meaning to all the other ways in which we use this term, Word of God. One last point. The Catechism of the Catholic Church, number 107, quotes Dei Verbum 11. We must acknowledge that the books of Scripture firmly, faithfully, and without error teach that truth which God, for the sake of our salvation, wished to see confided to the sacred Scriptures. What this paragraph of the Catechism is saying is that the Bible is true. There is no error in the Bible. Yes, no error with regard to truths for our salvation. We don't go to the Bible to learn scientific facts or geographical details. No, we go to the Bible to learn the truths of our salvation. The truths that God has revealed in Christ. The truths about God himself, God's self-communication. The truths about the world, about the meaning of our lives. The truth about ourselves. And in these truths of salvation, the Bible will never be wrong. We thank God for sending his son Jesus and for the apostles who believed in him. We thank God for the apostolic tradition through which we have received the scriptures. As we read the scriptures in the light of tradition, may we be guided by the Holy Spirit, so that we will encounter Jesus, the living and eternal Word of God, the perfect covenant. And then may we go out to share this news with others as we journey together with the church towards the fullness.
My dear friends, I wish you a very happy feast of Our Lady of Fatima. Today's feast commemorates the day when Our Lady appeared for the first time at Fatima in Portugal to Lucia, Jacinta, and Francisco in the year 1917. The message of Fatima is to pray, to do penance, and to also have a devotion to the Immaculate Heart of Mary, side by side the devotion to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. Penance would include a conversion of one's life, turning away from sin, and a turning back to God. When Our Lady appeared at Fatima to the three children, this is what she said and insisted. We must amend our lives and ask pardon for our sins. We must no longer offend God, our Lord, who is already so much offended. This year, on Easter Sunday, that is on 12th April 2020, all the bishops of the Catholic Bishops' Conference of India gathered together in prayer, led by His Eminence Oswald Cardinal Gracious, and consecrated the Church in India to the Sacred Heart of Jesus and to the Immaculate Heart of Mary. Today, I invite all of you to join me in praying the Rosary, for this is the prayer that Our Lady particularly asked us to pray. The Rosary is basically a gospel prayer and an immensely powerful and efficacious one at that. This has been my experience, and I know that it has been the experience of many of you too. Incidentally, it was on 13th May 1981 that Saint John Paul II was shot at in Saint Peter's Square, Vatican City, but survived the assassination attempt on his life. I'm convinced that it was our Mother Mary who saved his life. We shall now pray the Rosary with devotion, faith, and love in our hearts. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We shall begin by singing a hymn to Our Lady.
I'll sing a hymn to Mary, the mother of my God, the virgin of all virgins, of David's royal blood. Oh, teach me, Holy Mary, a loving song to frame, when me wicked men blaspheme thee, to love and bless thy name.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
We shall contemplate on the five glorious mysteries. The first mystery, the resurrection. Our Lord Jesus Christ rose from the dead, thereby assuring those who believe in him that after their death here on earth, they too will rise again. Let us offer this decade to all those who have fallen prey to various types of addictions, that the Lord may help them to rise again and free them from these habits. At the end of every decade, we shall sing only the chorus of the hymn, The Bells of the Angelus, that is, Ave, Ave, Ave Maria. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those who are in most need of your mercy. The Ave together.
Ave, Ave, Ave Maria. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria.
The second glorious mystery, the Ascension. After his resurrection from the dead, Jesus stayed for 40 days here on earth to demonstrate to his disciples that he was truly alive and to strengthen them for the mission he had entrusted to them of proclaiming the message of salvation. He then ascended into heaven to be seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. Let us offer this decade to all those who have died, especially our near and dear ones, that through our supplications, they too may ascend into heaven and see God face to face. The Our Father altogether.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those who are in most need of your mercy. The Ave together.
Ave, Ave, Ave Maria, Ave, Ave, Ave Maria.
The third glorious mystery, the descent of the Holy Spirit upon the apostles. On the day of Pentecost, the Holy Spirit came upon the apostles, and they began to speak in tongues, and the people gathered there heard them speaking in their own language. Let us offer this decade for peace, harmony, and unity in our families, in our communities, and in the whole world, where people are united in the language of love. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those who are in most need of your mercy. The Ave together.
Ave, Ave, Ave Maria. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria.
The fourth glorious mystery, the Assumption of Our Lady, body and soul into heaven. To those who have faith in God's mercy, there is always hope that with God's help, we will overcome and find solutions to any problems in life. Let us offer this decade for the COVID-19 patients, their families, for the doctors working to find an effective vaccine to combat this illness, for the migrant workers and their families, and for all others who are faced with tough and challenging situations, that God may fill them with hope and courage. Together.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, Pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those who are in most need of your mercy. The Ave together.
Ave, Ave, Ave Maria. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria.
The fifth glorious mystery, the coronation of Our Lady as Queen of Heaven and Earth. Let us offer this decade in thanksgiving for all the doctors, the nurses, the caregivers, the police, the social workers, and all those involved in the care of the sick of the coronavirus patients. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those who are in most need of your mercy. The Ave together.
Ave, Ave, Ave Maria. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria.
Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy. Hail our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To thee we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this vale of tears. Turn then, most gracious advocate, thine eyes of mercy towards us, and after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary. Let us pray. O God, whose only begotten Son, by his life, death, and resurrection, has purchased for us the rewards of eternal life. Grant, we beseech thee, that meditating upon these mysteries of the Most Holy Rosary of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we may both imitate what they contain and obtain what they promise through the same Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Litany of Our Lady. Lord, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Christ, have mercy on us.
Christ, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
God, the Father of heaven,
have mercy on us.
God, the Son, Redeemer of the world,
have mercy on us.
God, the Holy Spirit,
have mercy on us.
Holy Trinity, one God,
have mercy on us.
Holy Mary,
pray for us.
Holy Mother of God,
pray for us.
Holy Virgin of Virgins,
pray for us.
Mother of Christ,
pray for us.
Mother of Divine Grace,
pray for us.
Mother Most Pure,
pray for us.
Mother Most Chaste,
pray for us.
Mother Inviolate,
pray for us.
Mother Undefiled,
pray for us.
Mother Most Amiable,
pray for us.
Mother Most Admirable,
pray for us.
Mother of Good Counsel,
pray for us.
Mother of our Creator,
pray for us.
Mother of our Savior,
pray for us.
Mother of the Church,
pray for us.
Virgin Most Prudent,
pray for us.
Virgin Most Venerable,
pray for us.
Virgin Most Renowned,
pray for us.
Virgin Most Powerful,
pray for us.
Virgin Most Merciful,
pray for us.
Virgin Most Faithful,
pray for us.
Mirror of Justice,
pray for us.
Seat of Wisdom,
pray for us.
Cause of our Joy,
pray for us.
Spiritual Vessel,
pray for us.
Vessel of Honor,
pray for us.
Singular Vessel of Devotion,
pray for us.
Mystical Rose,
pray for us.
Tower of David,
pray for us.
Tower of Ivory,
pray for us.
House of Gold,
pray for us.
Ark of the Covenant,
pray for us.
Gate of Heaven,
pray for us.
Morning Star,
pray for us.
Health of the sick,
pray for us.
Refuge of sinners,
pray for us.
Comforter of the afflicted,
pray for us.
Help of Christians,
pray for us.
Queen of angels,
pray for us.
Queen of patriarchs,
pray for us.
Queen of prophets,
pray for us.
Queen of apostles,
pray for us.
Queen of martyrs,
pray for us.
Queen of confessors,
pray for us.
Queen of virgins,
pray for us.
Queen of all saints,
pray for us.
Queen conceived without original sin,
pray for us.
Queen assumed into heaven,
pray for us.
Queen of the Most Holy Rosary,
pray for us.
Queen of families,
pray for us.
Queen of peace,
pray for us.
Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world,
spare us, O Lord.
Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world,
graciously hear us, O Lord.
Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
We fly to thy patronage, O Most Holy Mother of God. Despise not our petitions and our necessities, but ever deliver us from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. Defend, we beseech you, O Lord, by the intercession of the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, this your family from all adversity, and being prostrate before you with all our hearts, mercifully protect us from the snares of the enemy, through the same Christ our Lord. We shall pray the Memorare together. Remember, O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to thy protection, implored thy help, or sought thy intercession, was left unaided. Inspired with this confidence, I fly unto thee, O Virgin of Virgins, my Mother. To thee I come, before thee I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the Word Incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in thy mercy, hear and answer me. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Through the intercession of Our Lady of Fatima, may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We shall now conclude with a hymn to Our Lady of Fatima. O come to the throne of grace, O come to the heart most pure, to Mary a hope of life, in whom salvation is sure. O Lady of Fatima, Immaculate Mother of Grace, oh pray for us, help us today, the hope of the human race. Have a lovely evening with your family.